Scientists discover new ancient human species. What's up, friends, and welcome to Inform Overload. I'm your host, Johnny Pompadour Prince Rogers. And if you happen to be new to the channel, we find the most interesting news stories on the internet and then we make them more entertaining. Plus, don't forget to stick around to the end where I will be answering some of your comments from previous videos. You wouldn't want to miss that, would you? What's up, my Homo sapiens? It's time to meet a new human species known as Homo lozenensis. Look, I'm not a scientist, I don't know how to pronounce that name. Let's just call him HL. Researchers have recently found a new discovery of an ancient human that existed 50,000 to 67,000 years ago. The discovery was made on an island in the Philippines, and after studying the bone remains found for 12 years, they believe that these humans were under 4 feet tall. The origin of the name for these ancient humans comes from Luzon, the name of the island where they were discovered. After finding the bones back in 2007, the research team made several trips back to the large island in 2010 and 2015, finding even more. On the return trips, they discovered toe bones, finger bones, parts of femurs, and even teeth. The reason it took so long for this information to come out is because the researchers needed to clarify what exactly these bones belonged to. It was nothing like they had ever seen before. A statement by the team was published in Nature magazine that reads, "These specimens displayed a combination of primitive and derived morphological features that is different from the combination of features found in other species in the genus Homo, including Homo sapiens, and warrants their attribution to a new species." This isn't even the first time that we've discovered a new relative to humans. In fact, the discovery is the fourth one in just 15 years. In 2004, they discovered a species nicknamed the Hobbit in Indonesia. Another species was identified through finger bones in 2010, found in Siberia. And in 2013, in an African cave, they discovered another human relative with mixes of modern and primitive features. Researchers, though, are still kind of scratching their heads as to how and exactly why this ancient human could have ended up on the island. Some suggest that a storm may have swept into Luzon, and due to the isolated environment on the island, their evolution into a smaller species that mostly kind of hung out in trees would have made sense. These discoveries, regardless of how strange they may be, they still help us better understand our weird ancestry of where we all came from. For example, Homo sapiens and Homo neanderthals walked the earth at the same time as this new species, meaning that there were once many different strains of humans, small and tall, walking the earth. I know what you're saying. Johnny, we already have that. Think about it in a different sense though. Yes, we as Homo sapiens all vary in size and race, but we're still all Homo sapiens. These were different mixes of humans. We're just the ones that outlasted the others. In an interview with NPR, the director of the Smithsonian Human Origin Program, Rick Potts, had this to say. "The one thing this new discovery makes clear is that the more we learn about the history of our species, the stranger it all gets. The evolution of Homo is getting weirder and weirder." I want to hear your thoughts on this story though, so comment down below with what you think about this new discovery of human species, HL. Or if you can tell me how to pronounce that name, I'd appreciate that in the comments below too. Now let's check out some of your comments from the video titled, "Doctors Discover 4 bees Inside Woman's Eye and She Had No Idea." Nate says, "They found 4 bees in my eye. Weird flex, but okay." Imagine if anyone said that to her after she told them that she had 4 bees in her eye. You're like, oh wow, impressive. Jimmy Chu says, "The real life wasp from the Marvel Cinematic Universe." Now there's something that we never considered. What if this woman was an evil villain and the wasp was just trying to do her job? What have we done? Caitlin Harris says, "Holy crap, I actually found this one out before IO. Do you want a job or something? Does a cover letter? Weird." Next comment. Ant-Man 1101 says, "Hey, it's Johnny, your stand-up comedy is funny. I hate the Ant-Man going in Thanos' butt." The negging, so much neg. Thank you for the compliment, and I'm not doing my job if I don't offend you at least some of the time. Trini Likes Potato says, "Just subscribe, you just are so funny. 3 exclamation points. I love that. Wow, thank you so much for subscribing because of me, and I love that, and I'll also forgive you for having potatoes in your name, but please, change it to Trini Likes Bacon. Thank you so much for watching Inform Overload. Hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video. And if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe before you leave. If you want any more videos like this one, there's gonna be a playlist on the side of the screen that you can just click on to make me stop talking at any moment. Or maybe you'll end up in another video of me and then you'll be like, ah, oh, God. From Inform Overload, I'm Johnny Rogers. Until next time, take care.